Meanwhile, the birth certificate of controversial Mayor Alice Guo at risk of being cancelled if proven she misdeclared herself as a Filipino citizen. The Philippine Statistics Authority says it is now investigating the requirements Guo submitted for her late birth registration, as well as the people involved in her application. Guo's identity has been put into question after a Senate hearing revealed her birth was only registered when she was already 17 years old.
Ang questionable kasi dito, Alvin, ay kanyang citizenship. Yung kanyang valid identity na magpapatunay ang kanyang birth certificate. So kung na-cancel po ito, ibig sabihin wala na po siyang birth certificate. Oh. And ano ngayon, maka-question ng kanyang citizenship. Kapag mayroon na siyang mga valid na evidences, pwede na natin i-block sa ating pong database at hindi na po makakakuha kahit sino ng kanyang kopya. And also, we will refer na po sa mga concerned na authority for the cancellation.
The PSA says it is also investigating 14 areas in the Philippines, including Tarlac, over the late birth registration of foreign nationals. Jeepney drivers and operators who failed to consolidate as part of government's POV modernization program urged to refrain from plying their routes. This as transport authorities begin their crackdown today on so-called colorum vehicles. The Transportation Department warns unconsolidated drivers who continue their operations will face hefty penalties and a one-year suspension.
Ikaw na mismong kusang operator na hindi nag-consolidate, alam mo na hindi ka dapat sa kalye. Dapat hindi ka na pumapasada noon pa. Dahil ang pinakamabigat dito is pag nahuli ka, malaki ang penalty, may revocation pa ng driver mo. Ang tagal na ng panahon na binigay ng gobyerno. In fact, 7 extensions po yung ginawa ng gobyerno. Nung nakaraang pang administration po to, I think they had enough time to really think. And just to be clear po, nag-decide po sila ha. Less than 20% po ang nag-decide, or way less 20% ang nag-decide na hindi na-consolidate. So I think binigyan naman po natin silang panahon.
Transport groups Manibela and Piston holding a protest at the Office of the Land Transportation, Franchising and Regulatory Board as authorities begin cracking down on unconsolidated PUVs. Johnson Manabat now joins us with the latest. Johnson, what more can you tell us?
Hi, Carmina. Good afternoon. Transport groups Piston and Manibela stage another protest in front of the Land Transportation, Franchising and Regulatory Board office in Quezon City against jeepney consolidation under the PUV modernization program. Manibela President Mar Valbuena and Piston Deputy Secretary General Ruben Bailon led the groups in holding a program urging the government to stop the consolidation of public utility jeepneys under the PUVMP. Jeepney units who are joining the protest are occupying portions of East Avenue, causing traffic in the area. According to Valbuena, they will fight for their right to still ply their routes even after the April 30 deadline for consolidation set by the government. Valbuena explained they have a 5-year valid franchise given by Congress through a law. Therefore, it can only be revoked by the Congress. Manibela and Piston are hoping for a temporary restraining order from the Supreme Court to stop the implementation of PUVMP. Meanwhile, Bailon begged for understanding from the public for causing traffic, saying they need to assert their rights. He explained that under PUVMP, commuters will also be directly affected because fare will definitely increase under this program. Hundreds of anti-riot police from Quezon City Police District are already deployed in front of the LTFRB. LTFRB is yet to issue any statement after this hour. Fermina.
Thanks a lot. Johnson Manabat there joining us on the line.